Yeah, making sure that I heard. Okay, so let's pick up with the topics. So the topic is about the physics of the big and the physics of the square and small. So do you have any idea about the general idea of what I'm going to talk about today? Sino may idea? Physics of the big, physics of the small, vis-a-vis. There's a different physics for the small scale, and there's different physics for the big. So, for example, you want to learn about black holes, there's another physics for it. You want to learn about planes and how they move, how fast they go. Each classical physics. Okay? So, let's move on. By the way, I mean background. Are you physicists? Are you also studying physics or so here's our outline. The first part, we are going to talk about macroscopic physics, the physics of the big. So things we see, Marvin. So like this ball, I will use that later. Classical physics was invented by who? Rich Dad. I love you, Dad. So good. I know you're a scientist. Okay? And we'll also talk about other classical physics. Next, part two, we'll talk about special, just an introduction to the special general theory of relativity. Anyone here? So, wanted to understand nature, how come we have different physics subjects, different theories, or different explanations for the same thing, for different things? Okay, that's kind of what I'll just put this forward right here. Okay, next slide, please. By the way, you know this, I'm having a hard time because I have a flu, and that's why I have to speak from the diaphragm and not from the mouth. Okay? That was great. Okay, next. So, I have here something. Okay. So, wrote the book. There's this very big book called Road to Reality, written by a famous mathematician called Roger Penrose. His first lines were, "What laws govern our universe, and how shall we know them?" So that's his. Those are the beginning lines of his book, Road to Reality. So yun yung mga questions: what are the laws of our universe, and how shall we know them? So, man from the earliest part of civilization, they've been concerned about those questions. So, pero yung kanina nila in-attribute, for example, nagkaroon ng bagyo, or pumunta ko yung bulta, ano yung sasabihin nila? And nagalit yung gods. So, we have to kill a virgin. Kailangan natin magtapo ng virgin sa volcano para kumakili yung
Ginawa niya sa pawn niya, pawn to E5.
ganun siya. Eh, may knight na may pawn yung kalaban niya. So, magkapantay na yun yung pawn. White pawn, black pawn. Anong ginawa ng kalaban? Pinain. Anong tawag sa movement?
Pasa.
Ayan, pasa. So, sabi niya naman, pwede ba yun? Weird naman ang move na yun. Hindi ko naman natutunan yung law na yun. So, yun pala. May ganong rule. So, ganun din sa physics, sa universe. Akala natin, understand everything, pero eventually, you'll find na meron mga extensions. Learn more about those things. Okay, so again, sa classical physics, you know the initial conditions, you will know the path. The term, the disorganized sa path, alam mo na yung five positions, etc., etc. So alam niyo ito, meron nung kaya na ito? Yes, magaling na yan. Alam ko na yan. Okay. So dito, wait a minute. Dito, magpapakita ko ng video kung gaano kayo dapat maging confident sa laws ng classical mechanics. Binigay na Newtonian dynamics. Okay? So, I'll just take this. Napaka-paper.
Okay,
so let's move on.
Okay.
Not so
situation.
before we go to that, may kwento muna ako. Kilala niyo ba si Michael Faraday? Si Michael Faraday is one of my favorite scientists, aside from Richard Feynman and Einstein. The story kasi ni Michael Faraday, he was not that educated. Hindi naman siya nakapag-aral sa sikat na universities. Pero he had colleagues from Cambridge, na maliit siya, hindi siya masyado magaling sa math, kasi wala siyang formal education. He was very curious, and he played with different experiments. So with magnets, wires, oriented. So what he did was, he built on this discovery by a certain scientist named Oersted. So na discovery Oersted is that you have this wire. So imagine with me, kailangan pag-physics, mag-imagine. You have a wire, padaanin na yung kuryente yung wire. Okay, alam niyo ba? Familiar? Padaanin na yung kuryente yung wire, magiging yung compass sa yung wire. Ano mangyayari sa compass? Change the structure, shape siya ng direction. So yung needle, ilang gagalaw. So that's miraculous. But it's not. Okay? There's an explanation behind it. And yung nag-propose ng explanation was Michael Faraday. So he proposed that as you pass current along the wire, this direction, that's right, make the right hand rule, and there will be a magnetic field per day. Right hand rule. So yun yung na-discover ni Michael Faraday. And discovered a lot of things as well. Na-discovered niya rin yung force fields. So di ba sa mga movies, ikat yung force fields? Siya rin yung nag-invent na. So, ang experiment, kaya niya nalaman yung force fields. Yung magnet, sikat ko na experiment eh. Lagay niyo yung bar magnet, north pole, south pole. Lagay ka ng iron filling sa taas. Ano mangyayari? Magkakaroon? Nakikita mo yung field. Okay? So, siya yung naka-invent yung term. Ngayon, yan dami-dami yung ginawa yung experiment. So, paano mo na nakakalito yun ang dami yung results. Ginawa ni Mike ni James Clerk Maxwell, kinumpay ni lahat ng results and sort of, he wrote four equations. He found out four equations that would summarize everything. And the main takeaway is that electricity and magnetism are one and the same. So, para lang sila, and you can